Welcome to Stinson Beach. This small community of about 500 people is located north of San Francisco in Marin County, just across the Golden Gate Bridge. Its broad sandy beach is one of the most popular in Northern California, attracting 750,000 visitors per year to swim, surf, and enjoy the coastal climate. Nestled between the Pacific Ocean and Bolinas Lagoon, the Stinson Beach area was used by the Coast Miwok people for over 10,000 years, who built boats and homes from willows and tule reeds. After European colonization, Stinson's sandy peninsula developed from tent camps to permanent beach houses over the last 150 years. If no action is taken, the community will remain vulnerable to future flooding from sea level rise. This is a 3D model of Stinson Beach. Here you can see the creek and lagoon, the beach houses, as well as Highway 1 and the Calle de Arroyo access road. Let's take a look at how sea level rise could impact Stinson. With just 1.6 feet of sea level rise, Stinson streets and homes are at risk from lagoon-side flooding. With no action, portions of these important access roads will permanently flood with even just a foot or two of sea level rise. Along with vulnerable underground utilities like water and septic, this impacts all residents, regardless of their home elevation. At 3.3 feet of sea level rise, some of these critically important wetlands are now permanently covered by water. On the ocean side, rising waters are increasing shoreline erosion and beach loss. After 6.6 feet of sea level rise, flooding impacts nearly the entire Stinson Beach Peninsula, from the lagoon to the ocean. A previous study by Marin County showed that several hundred properties are at risk of flooding in the next few decades. Let's go to a bird's eye view to understand what this means. Here's East Coot Creek. Normally, it wends its way quietly into Bolinas Lagoon. But when there is heavy rain in the steep upper watershed, that water runs downhill to the coast and the creek channel gets overwhelmed. This has happened several times in the past decade. For example, the New Year's Eve storm of 2005 caused East Coot Creek to overflow and flood several dozen homes. Here's the area that a 100-year flood would cover today. This kind of flood has a 1% chance of happening every year, or a 26% chance during a 30-year mortgage. Even without sea level rise, this extreme storm scenario would flood an estimated 50 homes, in addition to affecting local restaurants and public access to beach parking. With climate change, the odds of simultaneous flooding from both the lagoon and East Coot Creek increases. Here is Bolinas Lagoon, a cherished nature preserve that is an important bird sanctuary on the Pacific Flyway, with rare wetland habitat home to a number of endangered and sensitive species. However, as sea level rises, the rich wetland ecosystem changes to mudflats and eventually open water. With nowhere to go, the plants and animals that rely on the wetland are squeezed out. Additionally, the natural flood protection that the wetland provides for nearby homes is lost, resulting in more flooding in the community. On a sunny weekend day, the beach is packed with visitors. However, due to sea level rise and coastal erosion, Stinson's beach is gradually lost to the rising ocean. Over time, this means less beach area and access for visitors, lower tourism revenue, and without any action, the decline of one of Marin County's most beloved beaches. So what can we do to protect Stinson Beach from these future scenarios? Stinson partners are already carrying out short and midterm solutions and studies to decrease flood risk and buy the community more time. From utility upgrades to exploring protective dune and living levee feasibility, the community is starting to plan for higher water levels. Working together, we can make Stinson resilient to future flooding. Marin County is now embarking on a project to explore the feasibility of a range of long-term adaptation strategies for Stinson Beach. A team of scientists, engineers, and economists will work with local partners and stakeholders to evaluate how a series of adaptation options can reduce flood impacts over time as part of adaptation pathways. This planning effort is known as the Stinson Adaptation and Resilience Collaboration, and you're invited to join us. Stay tuned for part 2, Exploring Stinson Beach Adaptation Possibilities.